This, President Clinton can be heard telling Australian business leaders the day before September 11th, 2001, that Clinton had the chance to kill bin Laden, but didn't do it.
And I'm just saying, you know, if I were Osama bin Laden, he's a very smart guy. I spent a lot of time thinking about him. And I nearly got him once. I nearly got him. And I could have killed him, but I would have had to destroy a little town called Kandahar in Afghanistan and kill 300 innocent women and children. And then I would have been no better than him. And so I didn't do it.
So is that the thing? Was that the choice? 300 dead innocent people for bin Laden? Our next guest was head of the CIA's bin Laden unit from 95 to 99. Michael Schurer joins us with his reaction. Michael, was that the choice Bill Clinton had as you remember it?
No, sir, it was not. He's talking about an occasion in December of 1998, I believe, the Sunday before Christmas. Osama bin Laden had gone from his residence in south of Kandahar to Kandahar City to talk to Mullah Omar and the rest of the Taliban. He had stayed too late, did not want to go back to his compound, and the Taliban gave him a suite of rooms in one of the wings of the governor's palace. We had an asset who put him in that room, escorted him there, and reported to us where he was. The attack would have occurred in the middle of the night, and it would have killed no one but Taliban people and Osama bin Laden and his crew. It is an extraordinarily, what really disgusted me about it is not only is he a liar, and what papers do you think Sandy Berger stole out of the archive now? But he was laughing about it. He thought it was very amusing.
So let's be clear. You're calling Bill Clinton a liar. He told that story the day before September 11, 2001, and he is lying, flat out lying.
If you looked up the picture of the word lie, his face would be right next to it. What he's saying, sir, is that everybody else is more important than protecting Americans. If you had killed Osama bin Laden in 1998, you would not have had 9/11. You probably would not have had Iraq. But he is a monumental liar, sir. Wow. And I told Chris Wallace that several years ago, and as a result, I got fired from CBS because they didn't like me talking badly about their hero, Prince Bill.
So Michael, they fired you because you were telling them candidly about Bill Clinton and what you knew?
Well, after I was on with Mr. Wallace and I told him that, they had me on the next morning, and I told him he was a felonious liar. And that was kind of the end of my contract with CBS.
I want to move back just a moment, Michael. Where were you that day?
Once we had the information, we were sure where Osama bin Laden was, I drove in the car with the director of Central Intelligence, George Tenet, and his deputy, General John Gordon. Gordon's a very good guy. And we went to the White House. Tenet went by himself into the room where they were going to have the discussion about shooting, and General Gordon and I remained in the operations center, kind of pacing back and forth and watching the football game. And when he came out, Tenet didn't say a word. But when we got back in the car, he told us that they had decided not to shoot because they were afraid some of the shrapnel from the cruise missiles would have hit a mosque that was nearby, and that the Muslim world would rise up and attack Americans. Well, it was 3 o'clock in the morning. There would be no casualties, no one in the mosque.
Right.
And if you think that would cause a billion Muslims to rise up and attack you, then you are a racist of the deepest hue.
So, Michael, when Bill Clinton said the day before 9/11, back in 2001, to those Australian business leaders, he said, I could have gotten him, but I would have blown up this town of Kandahar. That is, well, first of all, it's a town of 400,000 people, so he really couldn't have blown it up. But that's not true because the technology, even back then, was to the point where you could really limit collateral damage.
You could, sir. And the question is, who is he elected to protect? Kandaharis or Americans? You know, we've lost an enormous amount of people because he ignored 10 chances, not one chance, sir. And we had several other chances where there would have been no collateral damage at all.
In your opinion, why did he not take action?
Because he's a coward, morally, and because he's also more concerned, like Obama, with what the world thinks about him. If it's hard for a president of the United States to decide to act to defend Americans, he ought not to be president.
Right, and I also understand he had a shot at him right before he left, and he decided not to take that shot in December.
Well, he certainly had an opportunity to respond, sir, after they almost sunk our naval vessel in Yemen, and he chose not to do that. He's a disgrace, sir.
Michael, I want to dial in somebody who, after 9/11, wound up in Tora Bora and was pretty close. It's time Geraldo Rivera joins us. Geraldo, you got a question for Michael?
Well, I think that my main beef with what Michael is saying is that he is mixing and conflating intelligence and what he witnessed with his own ideological spin. So what you have here with this gentleman who was dismissed from CBS by his own admission is, number one, an analysis on the military action. And then, number two, he is spinning it to his own purposes.
Michael, is that what you're doing?
Bill Clinton is a horrible man, a coward, and all the rest of it.
Michael, is that what you're doing?
That's why, in my view, he is impeaching his own credibility.
Geraldo is a magazine guy. That's fine.
One other thing. I was in
Canada. I know the intelligence.
One at a time. Michael, you first. Michael, you respond.
I know the intelligence. I know the people who risked their lives to get the information. And I know that Geraldo knows nothing except what he thinks. He doesn't know the facts at all.
Khartoum in Sudan when Bill Clinton tried to take out Osama bin Laden and bombed his house. I stood on Osama bin Laden's property in Khartoum in Sudan. So to you that Bill Clinton is a coward or a liar, you are being disrespectful and you are conflating your role as an analyst with experience with an ideological spinner. And that is not your role.
When Clinton bombed Sudan, dummy.
You are mixing
Osama bin Laden was in Afghanistan.
Opinions about this man with your experience.
All right.
What I have an opinion about is dead Americans who
have
didn't
you ever
have
been
to
in
die.
Kandahar, all right. Afghanistan?
All right. I think we're drifting away from what we started to talk to. Michael Scheuer, who headed up the bin Laden unit there for a number of years, we thank you very much for joining us live.
We do.
All right.
Thank you. So-